Y'all doing all this singing and carrying on. to singing and shouting, thinking about the goodness of Jesus.
Yes.
You know how it is. Woo.
Yeah, I do, because while y'all were singing, God gave me a song deep down inside, and it go a little like this. A real, real, Jesus is real to me.
Church, they put you walk into our church. I mean, this other preacher's church, the deacon would take up a special offering aside from the main offering for her alone.
That's good, Pastor.
Oh yes, Sister So-and-so was so good, she almost got me for all my money. I mean, all that other church's money. You know.
Me too. She got my wig, my VET, my AAA, my SSI, and my ARRP.
Deacon Jack, if you don't sit on back, praise God. But back to what I was saying. Where was I? Oh yes, but Jesus. Can you say but Jesus? Was in town and heard how good she was. One day the sisters and the mothers of this whole city, the whole church got together and decided to put a stop to it. I said they got up. They got up off their fat behinds. They set that hooker up. They had her sleep with a married man. You see, Deacon so-and-so was sleeping all over town anyway, so it really didn't make no difference. You see, church, in those days, you could sleep around, praise God. It just couldn't be with a married man. Now turn to your neighbors and say, how lucky. Now, I told this woman I was married. Hallelujah. I mean, this unknown man told this woman he was married. But she didn't care, church. Now turn to your neighbors and say, thank God. My wife busted me. I mean, the village busted this man and woman. And all hell broke out. They were getting ready to stone her. Ooh, I wish my wife would have stoned me, because then I wouldn't be paying all these alimony checks. You know what I'm saying? They were getting ready to stone her with all and many stones. But Jesus. Can you say what Jesus? Was in town. This woman had a savior. A good savior. Like I had a good lawyer. Now turn to your neighbors and say, he's a lawyer in the courtroom.
He's a lawyer in the courtroom.
Now, as Jesus approached this woman, he knelt down and he began to write on the ground. But when he got up, praise God. But when he got up, praise God. I said, but when he got up, there was no one around. Now, I know you're probably wondering, what did he write?
Yeah, what did he write?
He wrote, he who is sinning in town better make sure no stones around.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, watch me. Nay, nay on that one. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes.
Church, what I believe. This young, new, unexperienced pastor tried to say, if I could paraphrase, Jesus said, he without no sin, let him cast the first stone. Well, all right. He was letting the people know, no man is perfect.
Yes, Lord.
Him without no blame or been accused, let him walk a mile in his shoes. Saints, what I'm trying to say now, God's the only person to judge or give sentence to sins of man. He's in control of every life situation. In the midnight hour, when your pillow's full, soaked, wet, tears, he's the only one to wash your tears.
Yes, sir.
God wants you to give your whole heart and mind and soul to him. God wants you to give eternal life. God wants to give you eternal life. God wants you.
Yes.
God wants you. God wants you.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Church. He feels the presence of the Lord in here. Can you feel him? Can you feel him?
Yes, Lord.
Praise the kings. Kings, please. Come sing that song.
Sing it.
Preacher man! Woo! Yeah!
whatever it is you talk about, this God. You talking about God can do this and God can do that. God can only judge and forgive me for my sins. I hear you running your lips and talking about this God. My mother used to talk about this God. You know she was sick with that cancer. She cried all night. She cried all night on this God. She then goes to the doctor. And the doctor tells her she ain't got cancer no more. She then tells me that God healed her body. And that he has power and dominion over everything. Well, listen here, preacher man. I run this city and nothing goes on. I mean, nothing goes on without me knowing or saying something. This is my territory, but I feel like I'm missing something.
Yeah, Jesus.
Who said that? I feel like I don't have full control over everything. I once heard you say once you accept Christ in your life, he will give you that power, yeah, that power to step on snakes and people.
Correction, that serpents and demons.
Who said that? Preacher man, you know I respect you. Do not like those other pointy creatures that be at the club and the crack house. I want this power. I need this power.
Hey, yo.
And I want you to tell me.
Yeah, what's going on?
You know Jesus was turning the water into wine over here.
Yeah.
My smoke.
What's going on?
What's going on, dog? What's going on, man? We outside vibing, dudes. Taking you so
long, my boy. I know we was doing a stick up today.
Yeah, y'all got issues. Y'all need Jesus.
Who said that? Can't you two idiots see that I'm trying to get power? And why you not sticking up elementary school kids?
Man, I did that all.
Hey, yo, so listen, though, hold up. You say you're trying to get power like that new TV show on Star Wars.
That's not the power I'm talking about.
Nick, you know you out here in these streets with the power, running around like Bruno Mars.
I got a gun in my hand.
Hey,
you be going
out.
Hey, you don't get this game.
Hey,
you don't get this cut. Hey, drop it
up. Knock it off.
Amen to that.
I'm going to need you two later on to help me with something.
So, man.
But y'all going to need some new brains or something. Preacher man, you think this guy has enough power to give these two idiots some new brains?
I don't know about all that. I know he's smaller than Mike, but that's going to take a miracle.
Never mind that for now. They still might be useful. What are y'all doing? Get in line.
Get in line? What? Nigga, I ain't holding.
What am I getting in line for, man? I don't need no canned goods.
Y'all need Jesus, so just stay in line.
What do I keep hearing? Preacher man, we need this power. The game on power. And you said the best way to get it is through this cat. Call Jesus. The best way I see it is this guy, Jesus, has all the power. Jesus. Yeah, I'm trying to get me some of it.
Yo, yo, I'm down. Give me my phone, girl. You felt that one?
Yo, I felt it. Yo, what was it?
I'm gonna feel like fire, yo.
Like fire. Fire shot in my bones.
We're trying to meet this cat. So he can hit us off for a little something, something. Yeah.
You? Want to know Jesus?
Oh, you know what? I got it. I figured it out. Yeah. All right, so yeah, we trying to get to know this cat named Mark. Jesus. Why y'all ain't do it when I did it?
Jesus.
So now you're probably wondering what's going on. And for those of you
who have gotten a little lost, there's a few things. First of all, I'm your narrator, and I'm here to bring you up to speed. Now tell me, wasn't that a powerful first scene?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to run down the characters for you, and I need all of us to be on the same page. We were first introduced to him. Now, this is a man who knows God, but he's not sure of the Bible. You know, he sways back and forth, and he slips and he slides. And don't get me wrong, he's saved, but like some of you young kids says, he leans back every now and then. Now, he was truly called by God, but he gets off course from time to time, and he sincerely prays that God will deliver him from wholeheartedly from his demons. The second person we saw was Pastor Tony. Now, Pastor Tony is truly a man of God, a seasoned man in the ministry, a young man in nature, but spiritually he's well-groomed and anointed. God has matured him and has given him favor. Rumor has it that God has also given him gifts and talents. Y'all know what I'm talking about, healing and speaking in the other language. Now y'all act like y'all don't know what I mean. You know when he says, coming in a Honda and coming tie my bow tie and new a Toyota Corolla. You know what I'm talking about. I heard him say it myself. He truly walks under the anointing of God. As MC Hammer says, you can't touch them. Now, these three sisters and brothers, they all know the word, and they grew up in the church. And they will shout at the drop of a hand clap. Wait a minute, go ahead now. But they get confused with who their new dance partners are sometimes. They forget they have a new shout, and sometimes they do the old shout. Sometimes they do the old shout. Go ahead, Sister Hattie. Wait a minute. Doretha, Doretha, Doretha. Now she's a looker. I swear for cheese and crackers, if I was a year younger, I'd talk to her myself. I mean, I have my nephew talk to her. That's what I mean. Doretha had a rough life. Doretha had a hard life. Doretha had a scary life. Doretha, Doretha. Doretha had a past which involves just about the whole city. She was a true woman of the night, but it looks like she picked up the wrong trick, or should I say, God picked up the wrong hooker. In case you haven't figured it out yet, you all are part of the congregation. Now the church is fairly new and full of vitality. The musician is bad. The choir is bad. And we all be rocking. Now, Mr. Tino, that is one bad mother.
Watch your mouth.
Right on. He owns half the city via drugs, prostitution, and gambling. I said he is one bad mother.
Watch your mouth.
Right on. But there's something about him that you just can't put your finger on. Now, rumor has it that his parents died when he was a young teenager, and they both were apostolic preachers. They say he was bounced from group home to group home. Then finally, the streets became his home. Now, you know this would make him a preacher's kid, and we all know what they say about the preacher's kid. They're the worst. You know, it seems somehow, though, that this preacher's kid knows something about the word. I guess it's because he was pushed down through his mother's womb, or should I say his father's womb. Then we finally get to meet Beaten Down. Now, here we have your typical followers. They will follow anyone, anywhere. Dumb and dumb. Stoop and stupid. Retard. Looney-tune.
All right, we get it.
These three idiots want to be thugs so bad that they call themselves the disciples of thugology. They have been attending the school of how to be a thug for the last 2 years. Hell, they were in high school for 6 years and they still haven't graduated. You see, saints, this play took a turn for the better when the name of Jesus was called upon. Something happened when Pastor said he was looking for something special. You see, the Bible says, ask and it shall be given, and seek and you shall find. Then, saints, the move of God didn't stop there. There was a spirit of forgiveness in this place when Doretha came to the front and asked for forgiveness. Doretha came apologizing and saying she's sorry for her sins. She sounded a little bit like Anita Bacon singing, I apologize. You see, we have to learn how to say I'm sorry in life. Don't you know you can't get to heaven with malice and hatred in your heart? I feel a little bit of my help coming on here. I was asked to narrate this thing, but look how God has been moving. I'm so glad that I serve a God that I can feel every now and then. You can't hate your brother and expect to see God. You can't hate your enemy and expect to get into heaven. This young lady knew in her heart that she had done something wrong. She knew she had to repent for her sins. I can imagine God was pleased with her repentance. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor. Y'all ain't doing it now. I'm going to say it again. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor. God was not through yet. You see, God had a ram in the bush, or should I say God had a thug on the street? How many of you know that there's power in the name of Jesus? You don't want to believe me? Watch this. You on this side, I want you to say Jesus. You're not convincing enough. I need you to say Jesus. Okay, you over on that side, I need you to say Jesus. Say Jesus one more time. Now everyone in here, say Jesus.
Crazy.
Yeah, I went crazy. But you almost dead, like. So I covered you up with some sheets. The Reaper, you were real bad. But I heard some sirens, and I had to get out of here. The last thing I heard is that you left town.
What are you saying?
I'm saying I saved you.
What?
I saved you. You gonna repay me now, or you gonna repay me later?
Look, let me tell you something. Look, I changed. I ain't the same person that I used to be.
You changed?
Yes, changed. Look, something happened to me while I was away. I became stronger. I believed that I could change. You know what? No, I did change. And after last Sunday, look, I believe God can change me too.
You changed. Look at you, Dorita. You always gonna be the same hoe. The same prostitute. No. You didn't forget. Come here, Dorita. Come here. Take care of me.
Let go of me!
Who do you think you're talking to?
You, I said in Jesus' name, let go of me! Jesus! 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 Jesus!
I don't know what's going on right now.
Jesus!
Thank you, Jesus. I can't do it.
Jesus! Jesus!
I want to see you around.
Jesus!